Hi folks, Peach Mario back again with the fifth video about the Tilwiki 5 developer environment. So we are back at GitHub here. So if you search for Tilwiki 5, you will get a repository which is called Germolin Tilwiki 5. We will need afterwards. Or you can also create a new user account here. Yeah. So Tilwiki uses GitHub because it was the first service which offered free hosting for open source projects. But there are several others which were a little bit later, but still they have some great functionality. The next one of what I want to mention is GitLab. GitLab itself is an open source project, so it's easy to spin up your own instance if you want to. And it has continuous integration and continuous delivery built into the project. So this is third-party software for GitHub, and here it's built in. Great, have a look at it, gitlab.com. And the next one is bitbucket.org, where I also have an account and also delivers, creates possibility to have free repositories for open source and public projects. So just to let you know that there is a choice, it's not only one service which we have. Okay, you can create a new account or I can sign in. I called it Tilwi and gave it a good long password. Since I don't have any project here, it's the page looks like this, so you can read the guide how everything works, or we can start a new project, which we will do. So we will create a short test project, which makes it easy to push some test content without we don't need to take care so that we don't break anything, because if we break it, we just delete it and start over again. Okay, this is a public project. I can initialize it with a README file, so then I get an editor, which I don't want at the moment. But I want to have a gitignore file. Gitignore is important because we don't want to push everything. For example, if we load third-party libraries into our project, we don't want to push them. Most of the time, we don't want to push them. And that's what gitignore is for. Since Tilwiki 5 is a node-based project, so let's initialize it with node-based project. Okay, so create the repository. It will need some time, then it created the gitignore file, and it already made our first commit. So the project is really started. And here is the clone or download button. So just have a look here. This is Tilwi, this is the user and the project name. And there is the clone and download button. There are two possibilities to communicate with GitHub. Its first one is with HTTPS, or the second one would be with a Git internal protocol. So we are using HTTPS because it's a little bit easier. Copy it to the clipboard, and then we will start our editor again, which still has the getting started editor. We want to open a new folder. So here you can see you have the working files, you can close them, and then here is the project. We open a new folder. With my PC, I only have the drive C because this is a virtual machine. So I create a new folder here, which is all the Git related stuff. I call it Git. And with Tilwiki related stuff, I call it Tilly. And since this one is just a test project, I call it test. So with the test project, we have to go into the directory and say select folder. But test. Okay. There is nothing in it. We want to open the Git plugin, which is this small icon here. And we want to say Git clone. Yeah, we could say Git init, but we already created the project in the web, so that's why we have to say Git clone. Then we clone it. Username password is not needed because we just want to download the stuff. Say okay, it downloads everything, and there you can see there is our Git ignore. Now we want to create a new file. File new. Some text. Then save it. Control S, save it. It automatically wants to save it in the project directory, and I say test.txt as a standard text file. Now it's also here. You can select the text highlighting. So in this case, it's just text, but we could say, okay, we want to have JavaScript. So if I say if A, B, and so on, I would get some elements. And I also got some warnings because this doesn't make sense here. So let's say, okay, it's just text. Okay, save it. Then we open the Git plugin again, and there we can see there is an untracked file. So with Git, if you create new files, they are untracked, so we want to track it, so we select it. Then we can see what we changed. So everything which is green is new, and everything which is red is removed or deleted. So this one, and then we say commit with Git. This is the command which is used to really store the changes, and if we commit it, the elements, then we can push them to the repository. Then we give it some a commit message just for testing. We will see this message again in the web when we pushed everything. Then we say okay. Then because if everything is new, Git wants to know the username and an email address, because the commit messages are signed with the username and the email address. So I give it the username tillyv, and here I'm using an email address tillyv@example.com, which is just an example. So you use the real email address that you used to create the account. Okay, so now commit it again. Then the commit message, say okay. So the working directory now is clean. And then we see here there is a small indicator that there is one change, which is different to the repository in the web. Because if I have a look here, nothing changed. Okay, now we say push it to the repository. It uses the origin master branch. Origin is the default name of a remote branch. It can be any name, but the default is origin. And the branch that we have is master. Now we will have a closer look about this in the next videos. Okay, so let's push it again. So it pushes it to origin master. Then username password, we don't change it because we installed the Windows Credential Manager for GitHub when we installed the Git elements. So we can have a username, tillyv, and a password. and then we log in. Yeah, and the next time we push anything, these credentials, they are securely stored, will be used automatically. Yeah. Okay, so we successfully pushed fast forward. Status is done. Okay, so now let's have a look here. Say F5, reload the project. Oh, here it is. There is our test txt, yeah, with some information. Yeah. So yeah, that's the basics for this video. And in the next video, we'll go a little bit more into the details. Have fun.